So in this tutorial, we'll introduce joining datasets by attributes, specifically linking tables to vector datasets for analysis and visualization. This is a powerful way to examine tabulated variables, linking them to vector geometries via common entries, in this case, a column in the table and a matching field within the vector. There are two types of attribute joins with slightly different procedures. Today we'll cover the first, the one-to-one join, where there is one row for each corresponding feature or geometry. For a successful join, the entries must match perfectly. Thus, numeric identifiers are best due to complications with text such as special characters, spacing, and case sensitivities. Copying and matching entries between datasets is another method to improve the likelihood of a successful join. For the tutorial, we'll use the population and dwelling highlight tables downloaded previously. They are ideally formatted as the join information is readily available and boundary changes between census collections have been accounted for, requiring no external formatting. So, we can load table datasets into QGIS using the established procedures, double left-clicking or dragging and dropping into the Layers panel. So with the tables and corresponding boundaries loaded, we'll open the Layer Property box of the Census Division layer, which we'll use to demonstrate the procedures. We can use the Joins tab to perform one-to-one joins, and to create our join, click the plus icon. So the join layer is the dataset that we'd like to join, and the join field is the specific column or field used to link the datasets, while the target field is the corresponding field within the vector containing matching entries, in this case, the unique census division identifier. We'll also check the following boxes and specify the fields to join, as otherwise all fields are joined by default. Specifically, we'll add the population and total private dwelling counts and percent change fields, as well as the land area, population density, and two population rank fields. We'll remove the custom prefix to retain the original column names. Now in the Source Fields tab, we can see that the columns are joined temporarily and have been misattributed as text field types, a default in QGIS. Additionally, the join field names exceed the limits of the file format we're using. So to permanently join the datasets, we would have to export the dataset to a new layer. But to accomplish all three tasks at once, we'll use the Refactor Fields tool. In the Processing Tool box, we can search the tool and double left click to open it. So we'll close the tool description. And using the dropdowns, we can change the field types for the join columns. Specifically, we'll use integer for the count variables, which will be whole numbers, while for the percent change field, land area, and population density fields, we'll use double, the equivalent for the decimal number field type. Then we need to specify the parameters using a length of 12, and for our double columns, a precision of 2. Finally, we'll rename our fields to abbreviated headers less than 10 characters in length, the limit of the shapefile format we're using, so feel free to use abbreviations that are most interpretable to you. Now we'll save the file, providing it an output directory and name. I am storing it in the Joins demo folder and calling it jpopcd for joined population census divisions. Once complete, refresh the browser panel and load the joined dataset into the Layers panel. So with our fields correctly attributed, we can now visualize the join variables, applying a graduated symbology to the numeric fields. Specifically, in this case, we'll use the percent population change field. We'll select an appropriate color ramp for visualization, and for the census division layer, we can use pretty rakes to establish the value ranges for visualization, clicking OK. Now we can examine the spatial variations in the join variables across divisions within Canada. We recommend practicing these procedures on your own by repeating with the census subdivisions layer to familiarize yourself with the workflow. Once again, specify the join layer and the join information, in this case using the census subdivision unique identifier to link the datasets. For the demo, I've loaded a join subdivision layer I created earlier. Due to the data distribution at this level, quantile equal count was the method used to establish the break values for visualization. But toggling back and forth between the layers demonstrates how these procedures enable variables of interest to be assessed at multiple scales relatively quickly and easily. And on that note, if we wanted to determine trends at a broader level, we can use the Aggregate tool. So we specify the layer to be aggregated, and then the Group by Expression dropdown enables us to select a field to use in aggregating both the geometries and attributes of the layer. Since we are going to use the unique provincial identifier, the first three census division fields are redundant, so we'll remove them. We can specify the operator applied in aggregating the fields from the dropdown. So we'll use first value for the first two text fields, and for the percent changes, we'll use mean. Finally, we'll remove the population rank fields, and we'll save this layer in the same directory, calling it jagprpop for joined aggregated provincial populations. Once it's complete, we'll refresh the browser panel once again, load in the layer. And now we'll recalculate the percent population change field with the field calculator. So we'll add a bracket and then subtract the population in 2016 from that in 2011, close the bracket, and divide it by the baseline, in this case being the population in 2011, multiplied by 100. Once again, we can use the symbology tab to visualize the variables at three separate levels. So the final item I'd like to discuss is the graphics dropdown in the processing toolbox, which can be used to quickly assess data distributions, such as the feature counts in different categories using histograms and box plots, or variable relations between joined variables using the scatter plot tool. So we could specify the 2016 population as our independent variable and the total private dwellings in the same year as the dependent. Once run, we can click on the hyperlink in the results viewer to examine the relation. Unsurprisingly, there's a very strong positive relationship between the total population and number of private dwellings. So that concludes the one-to-one join, where there is one entry for each corresponding feature using the Joins tab. The procedures can be applied to join tables or link two or more vector datasets together, enabling the visualization of variables of interest. We also learned how to apply the Refactor Fields tool to alter field types of join data and use the Aggregate tool to examine trends at broader levels. We could iterate these procedures to combine multiple variables for examining changing variable relations between locations or over time. In the next demo, we'll examine how to perform a one-to-many join.